children, good morning to one and all. This is Sudha. In previous class we had discussed what is meant by solution. Okay, what is meant by homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures. In this class we will discuss the properties of a solution and what is meant by concentration and how we are preparing a preparation of saturated and unsaturated solutions. Okay, first, what are the properties of a solution? We know that solution is a combination of solute plus solvent. Okay, if we prepare a one homogeneous solution and if we pass it, if we take any solution, not a homogeneous or heterogeneous, just take one solution in a glass beaker. If we pass a light, if we pass a torchlight, like a beam of light, what will happen? The lights will not pass through it. The light will not pass through it. Okay, it scatters the rays. It scatters the rays. Okay. The particles in a solution are cannot be able to see with our naked eye. The particles in the homogeneous solution. The particles in the homogeneous solution can't be able to see with our naked eye. If they are dissolved, we can't able to see with our naked eye. Okay. The particles are unsettled. The particles are unsettled. If we not disturb it. If we undisturb it. If the particles are settled down, it is said to be a homogeneous mixture. They are said to be a homogeneous mixture. So the properties of solution, first point is, okay, the particles present in the solution can't be able to see with our naked eye. They can't able to see with our naked eye in homogeneous solution. If I take a salt plus water, the salt dissolves in water. We can able to see the particles present in that water? No. Why? Because they are all dissolved. So we can't able to see with our naked eye. First point. Second one. If we pass a beam of light, if we pass a beam of light, the lights will not pass through the solution. The light will not pass through the solution. They will scatter the light. They will scatter the light. Next. Third point. Okay. The particles are unsettled. The particles are unsettled until we undisturbed. In a heterogeneous mixture. In homogeneous mixture, the particles are always settled or not dissolved. They will be dissolved. Okay. Next. What is meant by concentration? Next is, what is meant by concentration? The amount of solute. The amount of solute dissolved in a, okay, the amount of solute dissolved in a saturated solution. The amount of solute, okay, the amount of solute dissolved in a saturated solution. Saturated solution at certain temperature. At certain temperature is called concentration. Okay, the amount of solute. The amount of solute dissolved in a saturated solution. The amount of solute that dissolved in a saturated solution at certain temperature. At certain temperature is called concentration. Is called, is called concentration. Okay, see, what is meant by concentration? The amount of solute dissolved in a saturated solution at certain temperature is called concentration. Is called concentration. Okay. Here the we can know concentrated and dilute solutions in next class. In next class. Okay. Preparation of saturated and unsaturated solutions. Okay. Take 1 cup and add 50 ml of water and add 1 tablespoon of sugar and stir it well. What will happen? The sugar will dissolve in water and add another 2 spoons dissolve. The amount of solute which can't able to dissolve in a solution, which not dissolve in a solution at certain temperature and pressure is called saturated solution. Okay, ma'am, if I take 1 cup of water, added sugar 1 tablespoon, it dissolves. I added 2 tablespoons, it dissolves. I added 3 spoons, it dissolves. If I added 4th spoon, it will not dissolve. Okay, it will not dissolve. Such type of solution is called saturated solution. Okay, it is called saturated solution. The substance in which solute will not dissolve. The substance in which the solute will not dissolve in a solution at given temperature and pressure is called saturated solution. Is called saturated solution. Okay. Again, I am telling what is meant by saturated. The substance in which solute will not dissolve. The solute will not dissolve in a given solution is called saturated solution. Next, unsaturated solution. Unsaturated solution. Okay. The substance in which solute will dissolve. The solute will dissolve in given temperature and pressure is called unsaturated solution. Ma, I take a cup of water and added sugar. No, I added 3 or 4 tablespoons. Okay. In which the solute dissolves, I added 4 tablespoons of sugar. The sugar is dissolved in water, no? Such type of solution is called unsaturated solution. Okay, such type of solution is called unsaturated solution. Ma, don't feel clear. I am again saying clearly, listen. Saturated solution means in which the solute will not dissolve. I added 4 tablespoons. It dissolves. If I added 5th spoon, the sugar will not dissolve in water. Okay. Such type of solution is called saturated solution. Until 4 spoons it dissolves. No. Such type of solution is called unsaturated solution. Listen again, I am telling you Telugu. Okay. Manu 1 cup of water tisukoni 4 tablespoons of sugar add chesam kada. 4 tablespoons sugar dissolve ayyunna dannemo unsaturated antaru. ఇంక 5th స్పూన్ 6 స్పూన్ యాడ్ చేసినప్పుడు అది డిజాల్వ్ కాలేదు చూడు, ఆ సొల్యూషన్ ని సాచురేటెడ్ సొల్యూషన్ అంటారు. అర్థమైందా? అన్సాచురేటెడ్ సొల్యూషన్ ద సబ్స్టెన్స్ దట్ డిజాల్వ్స్ ఇన్ ద సొల్యూట్ విల్ డిజాల్వ్ ఇన్ ఇట్ సొల్యూషన్ ఓకే అట్ గివెన్ టెంపరేచర్ అండ్ ప్రెషర్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ అన్సాచురేటెడ్ సొల్యూషన్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ అన్సాచురేటెడ్ సొల్యూషన్ నెక్స్ట్ సూపర్ సాచురేటెడ్ యు హావ్ డోంట్ నో Super saturated. What is meant by super saturated? The solute will dissolve in a solvent by increasing temperature. By increasing temperature is called super saturated solution. Ma, here I added 4 tablespoons. It dissolves. Okay, such solution is unsaturated. If I added 5th or 6th spoon. It will not dissolve. Such type of solution is saturated. If I increase the temperature, what will happen? The sugar or salt will dissolve in water by increasing temperature. Such solution is called super saturated solution. Such solution is called super saturated solution. Next, factors affecting the rate of dissolving. My next topic is factors affecting the rate of dissolving. Okay. Take 3 beakers. Okay. Add water and salt. Okay. Take 3 beakers and add salt and water to 3 beakers. Keep this first beaker undisturbed. Don't disturb that beaker. In second beaker, stir the solution with a glass rod. In fourth one, heat the fourth beaker. Okay, for heat the fourth beaker. What will you observe from this? Which one will dissolve fastly? First, the beaker. Here we are taking the salt. Okay. You can also repeat the experiment by taking the crystal salt. Okay. Crystal salt. Take the crystal salt and repeat the same experiment. Repeat the same experiment. Okay. Which one will dissolve fastly? Whether heating or stirring. The mixture which is we stir will dissolve the fastly. Okay. The mixture which we stir will dissolve the fastly. Okay. If we heating means it takes place to dissolve the solution. So here these are the factors. What are affecting the dissolving means? One is temperature. Second one is stirring. One is temperature. Second one is stirring. And third one is the type of the solute. And third one is the type of the solute. These are the factors affecting the rate of dissolving. Okay, listen again. I am saying, take 3 beakers with salt and water in each beaker. First beaker kept aside. Don't disturb it. Just add salt and water and kept outside. Second one, stir it well with a glass rod. And third one, heat the beaker. Okay, in which beaker the salt will dissolve fastly. Okay, in second beaker when we are stirring, it will dissolve fastly. If we increase the temperature, it takes little bit time. Okay, if you repeat the same experiment with the salt crystals. Okay, salt crystals. Which will dissolve fastly? Either salt or salt crystals. Salt will dissolve first fastly. Here the crystals want to dissolve and later they have to. Okay, first they have to disappear. Okay, so here the salt will dissolve fastly. So the three factors which are affecting the dissolving are number one, stirring. Number two, temperature. Number three, nature of the crystal salt. I mean solute. Nature of the solute. These are the three factors affecting the dissolving. Hi children. Good morning to one and all. This is Sudharam. In this class, we are going to discuss about concentration of the solution. Okay. Concentration of the solution and colloidal and what is meant by colloidal and suspension and how we are calculating the concentrator of a solution. Okay. In previous class, we know that what is meant by concentration, the amount of solute dissolved in a saturated solution at certain temperature is called concentrated solution. Okay. The amount of solute dissolved in a saturated solution at certain temperature is called concentration. If the amount of solute is present, if the amount of solute is less and solvent is more, then it is said to be dilute solution. Then it is said to be a dilute solution. If the amount of solute is more and solvent is less, then it is said to be a concentrated solution. Okay. Understand, ma? We know that solution is nothing but a solute plus solvent. Here, if the amount of solute is less and solvent is more, then it is said to be a dilute solution. Okay, it is said to be a dilute solution. If the amount of solute is more and solvent is less, then it is said to be a concentrated solution. Okay, we can know the concentrate the solution depending upon the mass weight present in the solution. So nothing but a mass concentration. Okay, what is meant by mass percentage? The amount of solute present in a 100 grams of a solution is called mass percentage. The amount of solute the amount of solute present in 100 grams of a solution. The amount of solute present in 100 grams of a solution, 100 grams of solution is known as mass percentage. Okay, it is denoted by W. Okay, mass percentage. The weight it is equal to weight of solute by weight of solution into 100. Here weight of solute is small w. Weight of solute is small w. And weight of solvent is capital W. Weight of solvent is capital W. Small W by, we know that weight of solution is solute plus solvent. So small W plus capital W into 100. It is the mass percentage. It is the mass percentage. The amount of solute dissolved in a 100 grams of a solution. Next, volume percentage. Next one, volume percentage. Okay. In case of weight, we can take it as a mass also. We can take it as a mass of solute by mass of solvent. Okay. See, next, volume percentage. The amount of solute present in 100 ml of a given solution. The amount of solute present in 100 ml of a solution is called volume percentage. Is called volume percentage. So, volume percentage equal to volume of solute by volume of solution into 100. Okay. Here solute is small v. Volume of solute is small v. And volume of solvent is capital V. Volume of solvent is capital V. So it is equal to small v by small v plus capital V into 100. It is the volume percentage. It is the volume percentage. Next, combination of mass by volume percentage. Next one, mass by volume percentage. Mass by volume percentage is equal to mass of solute by volume of a solution is mass percentage. Okay, mass of solute by volume of a solution is the mass percentage. In this model we can get a problems. Okay, we can get a problems. We can see.